especially by making high-quality education affordable to the poor. He is none other than Lieutenant General retired Arjun Ray. I request Mr. Arjun Ray to please come up onto the dais. To do the honors, I would humbly request the Honorable Chief Guest, Sri Tanvir Said, to grace Lieutenant Ray with Lifetime Achievement Award.
Mr. Tanvir Seth, the chairman of Brainfeed, Mr. Brahmam, and our distinguished lady and gentleman on the dais here. A lifetime achievement award is normally given to a person whose contribution is over or is about to get over. But in my case, I have many more miles to go before I sleep. And many more miles to go before I sleep. I am most grateful, sir, and I am most honored for this distinction that you have conferred on me. And I would say this is a reinforcement of the people who were able to execute the vision I had set out for them. And at this point of time, whether we are in education or whether we are in science or we're in politics or whatever profession we are, if we were to summarize the role of a leader, I would say the role of a leader is to give a vision, to share the vision, to convince the people that the vision matters. It is the energy which comes from the people that fulfills the vision. So the role of a leader is not only to give a vision, to serve a vision, but the greater role is played by the employees, by the people they are responsible for, who give the energy that drives that vision forward. Without that energy, the vision is meaningless. It is absolutely meaningless. It has got no value. So this award actually is, I would say, a dedication to the people who work with me tirelessly and who have been working for many years with me and continue to do so, for having translated this vision into a reality. On a more serious note, I firmly believe, sir, that future competition between nations and states is not going to be competition between competing political ideologies, between competing economic systems. It's going to be between competing education systems. We are living in the world of AI and machine learning, and we are moving into the neural age. It is the quality of education systems which will decide the quality of a nation, the quality of a family, and the quality of an individual, period. The challenge as I look at this landscape in our country particularly, and I would take Karnataka with great specifics. Our initial problem here, as everywhere else, was illiteracy. People who lacked the ability to read and write, and therefore, because they were illiterate, they had no jobs. Then we came to the second stage where people were qualified, but there were no jobs. So unemployment was the next problem that we had. And now the challenge is even greater. There are millions of children who have school degrees, who have university degrees, but are unemployable. Unemployability is the challenge for education today. And that unemployability is because our education system has focused too much on getting 100 out of 100 in science and mathematics. In the 21st century, academic rigor has been redefined. knowledge about